Welcome to QGIS 101. My name is Andreas de Jong. This is the third video in a three-part series. In the first video, I showed you how to process a digital elevation model. In the second video, I showed you how to derive a catchment. In this video, we're going to derive the streams of this catchment. I hope you enjoy it. The next step is to extract the streams. We're going to need the depressionless DEM from the first video and the flow accumulation grid from the second video. Our output will be the stream network of the Salma Dam catchment in Afghanistan. We will be working with QGIS 3.16 Hanover. Please make sure that you have the GRASS extension activated. Let's go to QGIS. Here is the flow accumulation grid which we made in our second video. And if I just switch on the satellite image, you can see there is a kind of a ridge to the south of the reservoir, and you can see these little streams which are flowing north towards the reservoir in this case, and also to the south here, but they kind of bend around and join the reservoir a little bit further upstream. Okay, let's switch off our satellite image. And just to remind you, the flow accumulation grid measures all the grid cells which contribute to the flow of every downstream grid cell. So if I pick this stream here and press on information, click on it, you can see 639, that's the number of upstream grid cells, 1461, 1658, 1851, and so on. So you can see as we move down the stream, the number of contributing grid cells increases. So the number of upstream grid cells increases. Now, this is a very important concept because it allows us to define what is a stream. We want to extract the streams from this digital elevation model, but obviously we don't want to have every little tributary on it. We just want the main streams. So there are several ways of doing this. But basically, what we want to define is how many upstream pixels are required to start the stream. Now, one way is to go to Raster Calculator, and we look at the flow accumulation grid, and we say we want to see all the cells which are greater than, let's say, 2500. And then we need to save it as an output layer. I'm just going to call it 2500. And press OK. And what you see here is the zeros are less than 2500 and the ones which are in white are greater than 2500. So that's quite an interesting stream network, but there is another way of doing this, which is a bit quicker. We just duplicate our accumulation grid, flow accumulation grid. And then we go in here to symbology and in the min-max value settings, change the interpolation to discrete. And if you've picked the wrong one, if you go exact, you can see just exact numbers here. If you say discrete, you should see a little less than or equals to or greater than at the bottom. And we just want to have basically two classes, greater than, or let's make it three just for the demonstration. So the first one which we want is, let's say, 5,000 pixels, and then 2,500, which is the one we just made. And what you can see here is the dark blue lines are the streams based on a cutoff value of 5,000 upstream pixels, and the paler blue lines are based on a cutoff of 2,500. Now, it's up to you which number you use, but I think 5,000 upstream pixels is probably the one I'll pick for today. So let's remember that. Our magic number is 5,000 upstream pixels. What this means is 5,000 times by 30 times by 30. That's about 4.5 square kilometers of area in order to make the beginning of a stream. Okay, let's go to the processing toolbox and just type in stream. And the one we want is r.stream.extract. Double click on it. And let's work our way from the top to the bottom. the input has to be the filled DEM. Now, these are optional, but it's better to also add our accumulation grid. And we don't have a real depressions. Minimum flow accumulation for streams. This is very important. That's the number we've just derived, which is 5,000. Remember, that's 4.5 square kilometers. Now, these other ones are not needed, but under advanced parameters, let's increase the memory to 1024. And the region, I'm going to also define that as the same as our digital elevation model. The cell size, I'm also going to remind them that it's 30 meters. And this is also very important. The output type has got to be a line. Yeah. Now, there are three possible outputs. We don't need the flow direction grid, but the one we want is the vector layer here. But sometimes it doesn't work, so let's also export the raster layer, and we're going to do both as virtual layers. Press run. Okay, our task is completed. It has taken 179 seconds, so quite a bit of time. Let's go to layers and see what's happened. Switch off the flow accumulation grid. And we're lucky. We have managed to make the raster and the vector. Now, sometimes the vector layer is not created. I don't know why the reason is for this. But if you don't get the vector layer, don't worry. You can extract the vector from the rasters. And the way to do that is you just put r.to, so raster to vector. Okay. And we put the raster in. We say it's a line. And we smooth it, and again we say line, and that's it. Just run it. It should extract the vectors from the rasters. Okay, so we have our streams extracted for our whole grid, and what we'd like to do now is just to take out the ones which are inside of the Salma catchment. The way we do that is we go to vector and research tools, select by location, and we just say the ones which are within the Salma Dam catchment and create new selection. Just press run. Now, there seems to be a geometry error here and it hasn't quite worked. So we just go to change parameters and you see this little toolbox here. Let's click on that. Invalid feature filtering. Do not filter. Press run and close. Okay, it has selected all of our streams which are inside the Salma Dam catchment. So yeah, that looks okay. All right, so what we'll do now is we'll just right click on our selected layers and go export, save selected features as, and we'll save it as a shapefile. That's okay for the moment. And I'm calling it and say okay. Okay, it has extracted it. Okay, let's do a bit of cosmetic improvements. We'll make them blue, and our catchment is quite a dark. Let's make it a bit thinner and make it black. Okay, and let's switch on our digital elevation model, and I need to just switch that back to update canvas. Okay, I'd like to remove the stuff which is outside of the catchment, so I'm gonna just work on our catchment layer a little bit, and we're gonna make it inverted polygons. And the fill should be simple fill. And what we're going to do is make it white. Just say apply. Okay, so what is done is now it's put a white color all around the outside, but let's make it a little bit transparent. So opacity should be reduced. Say apply. Okay, so it gives us a little idea of what's happening outside the catchment. And seems a little bit dark. Maybe I'm going to make the DEM a little bit more transparent. Something like that. Okay, and our streams, maybe make them a little bit darker. Like that. All right, we have made the catchment and the streams of the Salma Dam in Afghanistan. I hope you enjoyed the video and see you in the next one.